Yes, I think I'm going out of my head over you.
I'm here with Tony Butala. He is the founding member of The Letterman. That's right, The Letterman. 50 years you've been performing, and he resides right here in Sharon, Pennsylvania.
Yes, I do, my hometown.
And the hometown is where this interview is taking place, at the Columbia Theater. Now, this is an odd location. It was damaged by fire. You purchased it back in the 80s.
Yes, I did.
And this will now be the new home for the Vocal Group Hall of Fame.
Yes, there are two reasons for that. First of all, a lot of towns have refurbished their old theaters. Thank goodness. Because you can't build these things anymore.
Oh, they're beautiful.
It's a 1,740-seater, and it was an old vaudeville home. Burns and Allen played on this stage right here. Houdini played on this stage. Will Rogers played on this stage. So many people, it's historic. But so often, you'll refurbish these things, they'll sit like white elephants because there's no use for them once they get them refurbished. Well, I thought, well, the Vocal Group Hall of Fame, we have all these vocal groups that could come in here like once a week, have a fabulous vocal group, Drifters, Coasters, Platters, Three Dog Night, Earth, Wind & Fire, and it would help bring tourism back to Sharon. Because when the steel industry moved out and Westinghouse, this became a ghost town. So I'm trying to do my best to try to encourage the tourism back to Sharon.
So you've really got a lot in mothballs right now that yes. You're waiting to bring out once this is completed.
Yes, the state of Pennsylvania said in order to get state funding, we'd have to have our own bricks and mortar. And we have this building and the building next door, which will be the museum. But we moved out of the building we were in because we were leasing. So then 3 years ago, the state of Pennsylvania had a little financial problem.
Well, the whole country, yes.
Yeah. So we're kind of on hold in limbo now, waiting for a couple of $1 million in state grants that have been committed to us, but they're just not in the offing yet. So we're holding on. This beautiful building, we hope to be open maybe within a couple of years.
50 years, you have been the mainstay of the Letterman. And that name, did you think that would last you for 50 years?
In the late 50s, when you got together with it, like I did, what could we call ourselves that's real cool? Well, school names are really cool then. There was the four freshmen,
yes.
The four preps, Danny and the juniors, the seniors, the sophomores, mm-hmm. And no one had used the name The Letterman. So I thought, wow, wouldn't it be cool? We used the letter sweaters as a visual aid for people to remember us. Well, then all of a sudden, we had a couple hit records, and the 60s came along. And all of a sudden, school names are so square and cornball.
And you're already, though, famous
all
with
famous.
The Letterman.
So I went to Capitol and said, we want to change our names. They said, are you kidding me? Three hit albums, three or four hit singles? And they said, wouldn't do it. We have $1 million. I wanted to change our names to the Three Ashtrays.
The Three Ashtrays.
Three Ashtrays. So had they let me do that, we'd be sitting here talking about the fabulous fame and fortune of all these albums at the Three Ashtrays.
Why the Three Ashtrays? Nobody was going with smoking. No, I mean, you would have really been ahead of the curve there.
Because we had a song called Smoke, Smoke, Smoke That Cigarette, which is anti-smoking. And we were going to put it out. Anyway, it's a good thing we didn't do it. We put the letter sweaters in mothballs and made the name mean us and us not mean the name.
Well, let me tell you that it hurts so bad. It makes me feel so
a little chilly here in the Columbia Theater. I don't know if you can see the smoke coming out of my mouth during this interview. While you were in your 50 years of entertaining, who are the people that really impressed you, the notables that you've entertained with and that you've met?
Because we were not called a rock act, we were a pop act in the rock era. We got to perform with people that wouldn't have a rock act with them. Jack Benny, George Burns, Red Skelton. We were regulars in the Red Skelton Show for years. We went overseas with Bob Hope, Sammy Davis Jr., Dean Martin, Milton Berle, Jerry Lewis.
I mean, they're all larger than life characters.
Yes, we got to work with all of them because of that connection with the pop.
The former Phoenix Restaurant and Bar is now a part of the Vocal Group Hall of Fame. So we've moved next door to talk about Tony's other enterprise, Vineyards, Butala Vineyards. You're a man of all seasons.
Well, that's one of my favorite subjects.
One of my favorite topics, too. He has 40 acres in Napa Valley.
Yep.
And what kind of grapes are you growing there?
I grow strictly the red Bordeaux style of Cabernet Merlot and a little Cabernet Franc.
So you have 40 acres in Napa Valley.
Yes, I do.
You produce the wine or do you sell the grapes? How does that work?
I do both. At first, in 1993 and 94, I had my own Castlebrook label, but then a divorce and things like that happened, and you got to go to plan B. So I started selling my grapes to the wineries. Stag's Leap Winery for 14 years bought my grapes. And they put my grapes in some of their better quality Cabernets and Merlots were coming out. And then in 2006, Artesa came along and they wanted
wonderful,
to buy my grapes.
Wonderful label.
So as you see the light at the end of the tunnel, see, when you pick your own grapes, you have a 3-year wait of investment of no income. But when you sell your grapes, you get money right away from the per ton. So Artesa, as I found a thing about in 06, I started keeping back some. So since 07, I resurrected Castlebrook, and I have my 07 Ultra Merlot that I made in my winery from top to bottom. Okay, we'll open this little bugger, and let's sample what it tastes like. Wow, let's see.
Happy New Year.
see if it's pliable, first of all.
Okay.
This is pliable. And then you smell it, there's no vinegar. And then you you pour it. Just a taste, because you want to take a look at it. The taste of wine is very much influenced by your oculary, your eyesight. So you look for the color, and then you swirl it. You want to shake the molecular structure up so you can really explode in your nose. And then you stick your nose in the glass.
Oh, my.
As you get the nuances. Mm,
yes.
The bouquet. And usually a good wine will have a good shield and have good legs.
Good legs, yes.
And it's not coming down yet. But so then we, let's toast to good times ahead, friendship and happiness and love for the whole world.
Tony, this has been a wonderful, chilly, but wonderful afternoon.
Thank you. I really enjoyed it too.
I mean, you are really an amazing guy, and I'm so glad you decided to come back to Sharon, Pennsylvania. The Letterman, the Vocal Group Hall of Fame, and my goodness,
I don't care
the success you've had with your vineyards.
Thank you very much. Wherever you go in the world, though, I don't think what you've achieved, there's nothing like coming back to your hometown if you have good roots.
And you are doing an amazing job, and really, continued success. Really, I've enjoyed this immensely.
Thanks for having me on.
Thank you for coming. Cheers.
In Croatian, we say, živjeli.
For more information regarding any content from our show, please visit our website, caseymaloneshow.com. Your comments and ideas are appreciated. The Casey Malone Show is sponsored in part by Denise and John York and the DeBartlow Corporation.
You are the angel glow that lights a spark. The very thing that I know are what you are. Someday my happy heart will hold you, and someday I'll know that magic divine when all the things you are. Bye.